This video camera was found deep in the catacombs. It was picked up by a catacomb explorer, some of the people who wandered down there. It was given to me. I looked at the tape. It's very bizarre. It's a point of view shot. The point of view shot is somebody just walking forwards with the camera. So basically, he's filming what he's seeing. Endless. Very deep inside the catacombs, other than the point of view shots, are pictures of bones. Human bones. These were the poor Parisians who died over the last 1,000 years. This person occasionally stops and he photographs bones, often in the shape of an arrow. These arrows point in a direction. Occasionally also, he stops to photograph roomfuls of bones. Which means that he's very, very deep inside the catacombs. What happened to him? Nobody knows. Normally, I'm a freelance filmmaker. I shoot anything from fashion to documentaries.
Attendez. Je suis pas prêt.
I mean, there are 400 miles of tunnels like this. So I brought the tape to a cataphile, an urban explorer. Cataphiles are strange people. They're people who have this passion for the catacombs. These people go down there to find new passages, new entries, new bones, new skeletons. Lazar is probably the person in Paris who knows the catacombs better than anyone. So according to Lazar, the person is not someone who knew his way around. My intention right now is to go down with a still photographer, Vincent, a friend. I'm also going to take an excellent sound man, Francis, to spend some time in the catacombs and try to solve the mystery. There are ways to match things up, to try to identify where this person was in the catacombs. At times you'll see there's signs. Painted signs on the wall, which is not uncommon. People have been painting in the catacombs for centuries. So it is possible with these paintings that we may be able to retrace his itinerary to some extent. After about 40 minutes of these point of view shots and these pictures of bones, the person begins to walk faster and faster. Then he begins to run. We hear his breathing get louder and louder, as though something was scaring him. He's frightened. Occasionally he stops, perhaps to try to decide which way to run among all the many different corridors. He's running faster and faster and faster, deeper and deeper into the catacombs. And all of a sudden, he drops the camera. The camera just drops on the ground and keeps rolling. And you see his feet just run away. And it keeps rolling until it runs out of tape. Francis and I are going to now meet the director of the Catacombs Museum, who has nothing to do with the cataphiles, doesn't even want to know about the cataphiles, but he may have some information, and hopefully he can let us look at some maps of the catacombs.
Mais alors, tout Paris.
In Paris, you have as many miles of tunnels underground as there are streets above ground. No one knows just how many passageways exist in the catacombs, but we believe that they go down over 300 feet. Some are filled with water, and many tunnels have collapsed over the years. It's an enormous maze. We think there are as many as 7 levels to it, spreading under the entire city.
How do you get into the catacombs? Illegally, of course. And the idea is to find an entrance. The problem is that the authorities keep shutting him down. Apparently, Lazar has found a new way to get in, but it's way out from the center of town. It's actually on the edge of the city, through the railroad tracks for about a mile. And then there's a little hole in the ground, and we have to crawl through it. And
he could still be down there.
Maybe he found his way out. Nobody. We'll try to solve the mystery if we can.
So the trick is to wash not only your feet, but your head.
I have never been very deep into the catacombs before. Very few people have. I don't know what to expect. Already when you enter the catacombs, the first few hundred yards are already scary. Yes. You have to crawl. You can bump your head. It's pitch black. As you're walking, you trip upon rocks, holes. You can fall pretty deep.
Really, the tunnels are so incredibly vast, our chances of finding the lost man are probably very slim. But we do know by looking at his video that he got as far as these lower levels, where we are now.
Is it okay?
Anybody can get lost in here. Anyone can get lost in here. I mean, imagine just running out of batteries on your flashlight. You're dead. You're dead. It's true. I mean, just look at this. You lose your flashlight. What happens? We're finished. We're dead.
This is my own opinion, but this is far too deep for an amateur to be messing around. He must have lost his way down some passage and died.
There's a manhole up there, which is supposed to be open
to get out, but apparently it's locked or
Liz is having a difficult time.
Open me up.
You're gonna have to backtrack and walk back the 5 or 6 miles that we had coming here. That would be hours and hours and hours. And let's hope our batteries don't die on us in the meantime. So close, yet so far. We're 10 feet from freedom and we can't get out. It's about 60 feet from here to the street.
Well, it looks like a manhole. Oh, there's no way to get out of there.
You need to be a mountain climber to get out of there. I think I saw this on a tape. This figure with the arms outstretched, the legs outstretched. And I think after this, the camera turns right.
Donc là, on va passer sur un passage de
deep this is. We could be walking on thousands of corpses here. Look how deep this thing is. It looks like the killing fields. According to Lazar, if you search through these catacombs, you could find the gate to hell. Perhaps this person found it by accident. This is the gate to hell. Sorry that I got my buddies involved in this. I'm very tough. We didn't solve the mystery. I don't think anyone ever will. There's too many miles of tunnels in there. We'll never understand what frightened whoever it was that dropped the stake.